Before snakes became the slithering predators we know today, there was a time when they had legs. That's right, millions of years ago, some snakes still retained their limbs. And one of the most fascinating examples of this is the Najash Rionegrina. This ancient snake wasn't just another reptile. It was a crucial missing link in the evolutionary history of snakes, revealing how they transitioned from legged lizards to the sleek, limbless hunters we see today. For years, scientists debated the origin of snakes. Did they evolve from marine reptiles like the Mosasaurus, or did they come from land-dwelling lizards? The discovery of Najash in Argentina, dating back 95 to 90 million years ago, provided a groundbreaking clue. Zahir, a scientist from the University of Sao Paulo, stated that this may be the most primitive snake ever found, and that we can now reject the hypothesis of marine origin. This suggests that at least some snakes evolved from burrowing lizards, rather than ocean-dwelling reptiles. Blair Hedges, an evolutionary biologist, also weighed in, saying in one fell swoop, "This new fossil kind of casts doubt on the aquatic hypothesis." Unlike modern snakes, Najash still had functional hind limbs and a pelvis. It even had sacrum, a bone that connects the pelvis to the spine, something modern snakes completely lack. This means these legs weren't just vestigial leftovers. They likely played a role in its movement. So what were these legs used for? Scientists believe they may have helped Najash in burrowing, stabilizing its body, and even aiding in mating. It wasn't fully slithering like today's snakes, but it was adapting to a new way of moving, blending limb use with body undulation. One of the most exciting aspects of Najash's discovery was its skull. Unlike modern snakes, Najash retained a well-developed jugal bone, or cheekbone, giving it a more rigid skull structure. This likely limited how wide it could open its mouth and how much it could move its head. Modern snakes have evolved incredibly flexible jaws, and it allows them to eat much larger prey than their heads. This process is called pterygoid walking. It involves the snake's jaws inching forward, gripping and pulling prey into their mouth in a rhythmic motion. Despite their common myth, snakes don't actually unhinge their jaw. Rather, their jaws are loosely connected by stretchy ligaments. But Najash didn't have this ability. Its skull was more rigid, meaning it likely couldn't consume prey much bigger than its head. Instead, it likely focused on smaller vertebrates and invertebrates. This is things like lizards, early mammals, and possibly juvenile dinosaurs. Among its likely prey were sphenacodontids, crocodiliforms, and even small theropod dinosaurs. With all this information, we know that Najash was a predator, but it wasn't ambushing or swallowing large animals whole like modern pythons or boas. It really was a fascinating creature that gives us a rare glimpse into the past, when snakes were still adapting to their new evolutionary path. It wasn't just a snake with legs, it was an evolutionary bridge, proving that at least some snakes evolved from land-dwelling lizards rather than ocean-dwelling reptiles. Its legs weren't just remnants of the past, they were an essential part of its lifestyle. And while it may not have had the jaw flexibility of modern snakes, it was a formidable predator in its own right. Najash may not have been the largest, almost deadliest snake, but it played a crucial role in the story of evolution, helping pave the way for the legless serpents we know today.